Greetings and salutations, everyone. My name is Featherhoof, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild, where Link has decided to give up his quest already. He's like, you know what? I could go save Hyrule, or I could get a sweet gig as an act, you know, as a woodcutter. I mean, look, he's got this badass axe. I mean, look at this bad boy. And then he was just laying around. So now, we're gonna go cut down some trees. I mean, this is something so cool. This game is so interactable. Just check this out. And a blah. And behold, I now have a bridge. Hello, bridge. This is so cool. These are things like, when I was playing the game for the first time, I was so, like, astounded to find little things like that. I mean, yes, the game does tell you. Like, if you listen, you pay attention, the old dude does tell you, you know, he mentions, like, hey, if you put your hips in the right way, the tree will fall when you cut it in certain ways and blah and whatever the fuck else. Okay. But right now, we've decided to change professions again from woodcutter to pest controller. Hi! Damn it! Blah. Don't give me that. Whoa. Damn it. You're going to get it. And now he got it. Blech. The one weapon I'm not particularly fond of in this game so far, and it is definitely the spear types. Those seem to be like way weaker than the other type of weapons, and I don't know why, and therefore I don't know why they're useful. Other than, you know, they keep an enemy at a distance. Other than that, eh. Okay, so we now have our first different type of arrow. We have fire arrows, which might come in handy soon. Maybe. Possibly. But I don't really have to worry about the cold that much because I got my new warm doublet. Don't I look awesome? I mean, it looks pretty basic. And I still... I've always played Zelda. I've played Zelda for eons and years and everything else now. And the one thing that Link has always had, with rare exceptions, like during some of the openings and stuff, he won't have it. But you always see him. He always dons a hat at some point. And to see him sans hat just feels so wrong. I mean, dig in the sideburns there, pal, and really love the ponytail, but no hat? Gotta have a hat. Ugh, it's one of those things that, like, when I'm playing my personal file, I like every outfit gotta wear something on his head. The pieces of armor and stuff or anything where it's like it's not covering his head. I'm like, I'm only using that if I have to. Other than that, nah, screw it. Ain't gonna use it. This is Link. Link wears hats. Damn it, that's what he does. You know, besides saving princesses. What is the plural of princesses? Ooh, rushrooms. A mushroom that can grow almost anywhere, but prefers ceilings than sheer cliffs. Ceilings? I don't remember seeing any on ceilings. All right. Cook it before eating to temporarily increase your movement speed. Nifty. Okay, how to move? This one actually... This part right here actually killed me quite a few times. Gotta remember... It's like... Okay, it's that little cliff there. Actually, because... If I fall from here, it's instant death. I'm totally going to hit up a save right now. I don't have all the stamina bars I'm used to having. I don't have the equipment I'm used to having that lets me climb sheer cliffs faster. God damn, I've become so accustomed to that. I'll take you. And I'll take you. Actually... Because I really didn't play much of Skyward Sword. I only got to play a little bit before I lost my patience with it. That, I'm not that used to the... Like, when I first started playing this, I was not used to the stamina bar. It really screwed with me. I'm like, what? Why can I only do certain things? Why is this thing deplete so damn fast? What am I doing wrong? So... Like I said before, I understand why it's here. I understand its purpose. Because without it, you'd just be climbing everything, and it's like nothing would stop you. There'd be no sense of progression in the game. So that's that. It makes sense in that aspect. So here we are, shrine number 3. Yeah. We've seen all this, but I don't need. I skip it even in my own game, because here's the thing. There's 120 of these shrines I found out. Since last time I recorded, I found out there are 120 of these damn things. I'm not watching that cutscene 120 times. No, ain't happening. I like cutscenes. Unlike some of my friends who are just like, can I play a game? I hate the cutscenes. Wah! I like cutscenes. But that 120 times, I don't need to see the exact same thing 120 times. Thank you. Thank you for offering it to me, game, but ain't gonna do it. I'm sorry. Ah, the stasis trial. Possibly the skill I use the least. Like, in my full game, like, it seems very situational, and not many situations have come up. But then again, it's probably because I'm not doing much of the story. I just keep exploring the world. I mean, right now, as of this recording, the game's been out for over a week. I've done very little of the story. I've just been searching the world. And I found some cool things. Anyway, stasis. Stop the flow of time for an object. Stops an object in time while storing its kinetic energy. The stored energy will act upon the object when the flow of time resumes. Making good use of the stored energy can move even the largest of objects. Good hint. I like the hint. I shall show you what that means. First, we need to get across here. So what we do is we take stasis and nope! Time is stoppeted! The stasis room is cool. It is cool. Oh boy. Hi, Mr. Boulder. How you doing? Bye. Oh, come on. Rap! Oh god, I shouldn't have wasted it. So I can't get around it now. Damn it. This is a treasure chest up there, and I do love my treasure chests. As a completionist, has happened. Hello? There you are. Beep. There, now with it out of the way, another one won't fall, and I can come up and grab... I forgot what was in here. Ah, a shield. Yay for me. But I has no rooms. Oh, wrong button. Oh, give me this pot lid. Go away. Nobody likes you, pot lid. But we will take the Traveler's Shield. But I think it's my most powerful, so let's go to the weaker ones first. Remember my motto, and even to this day, it still stands. After playing the game for a lot, always use your weaker stuff first. Get it out of the way. Ah. Now I get to show you the funness. Actually, I'm gonna get rid of you. Your job's done for the time being. I'm gonna take you. This is the fun bit about stasis. This is my favorite bit. And we just hit the crap out of it. Hit it. Come on, hit it more, damn it. There it goes! I love doing that. That is like the coolest ability. I broke it. Your resourcefulness in overcoming this trial speaks to the promise of a hero. In the name of Goddess Hylia, I bestow upon you this spirit orb. You could take it to the bar. It's worth one free drink. But only if you ask for the bartender, Ted. If it's Brian, he will not, honor that. He will just look at you and probably have you kicked out. However, may the goddess smile upon you. And remember, Ted. Oh, big baby. That means one more. Hey, who told you you were allowed to come back from the dead? The dead must stay dead. That's just what. Whoa. No. Don't you dare. Ow. Okay, you know what? I hate the heavy weapons. I hate them with a passion. Go away. Blah. No, 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 no. You do not. No pokies. Pokies are bad.
God damn it.
Weak weapons from hell. You know what? Let's get at least one. I have a couple of Bokoblin arms. Let's get at least one spear and try it out, just so you guys can see it in combat. All right, now you're done. So that leaves us with this one. We have to go past the River of the Dead, which I found out why it's called that. There's a good reason why it's called that, and you don't want to test it. You really, really don't. I don't know how to get past it. At least as far as going in water is concerned. Now see, if I was not wearing the warm doublet, look at the temperature gauge down there next to the map. See how close that is to the blue? There used to be blue there. See how there's red on the opposite side? There was blue on this side. But because I'm wearing the warm doublet, the amount of fire that is deadly to me has now been lessened. Ooh. It's over here. I don't think I've ever been over here. Like, I just went to the... Ooh, it's a Bokoblin camp. I want to kill these Bokoblins because they're there. Besides, it might be a good thing that... Ooh! Oh, oh, oh! Fire arrows. Check this shit out. And they're... Oh, look at them. They're all sleeping. They're all sleeping. Oh, man, we're tired. We're tired Bokoblins. Oh, but when we wake up in the morning, we're totally gonna pillage and plunder and kill. If only, you know, all we have to do is make it through the night. Nope! Oh, I love it. Excuse me. I'm burping in. I have lots of burpage today. Nah, don't need it. Don't want it. We're good. Oh, I love it, love it, love it, love it. Of course, I now just realize I blew up the treasure chest. That's bad. Unless it's over here and it got blown all the way over here. Was this always over here and I just totally missed it? Well, it doesn't matter. I'm here now. Oh, more arrows. Yay for me. And these guys slept completely through that shit. Yeah, let's see if we can just kill you in your sleep. What? He survived that shit? Well then, it's time to spear you. And you first. You want? Oh, he wants first? Oh, he wants second dibs. Oh, okay, well, fine. I am nothing if not a pleaser. I definitely like to please. He wants to die, but by all means, I will oblige. The fool. The absolute fool. More arrows, yay! To replace the ones I wasted. Which, by the way, sometimes when you miss, or even sometimes when you hit enemies, the arrows, like, stay for some reason. Alright, I see nothing. Let's continue on. Whoa, no, I was trying to... Okay, I didn't die, so that's cool. Now we are in the snowy place of snow. We will find our fourth shrine. But you know what? Why not? Let's have a little fun. Let's see how Link dies. Because this was like an unexpected death. Because I've swam in water. I was just like, swimming in water? I got this. I'll just go out to the little boat out there. I want to go check out that boat. Oh, how naive I was. What a fool. I was like, that's not a problem. I'll just, you know, swim out to the boat. Nothing to worry about here, folks. Look at that. Nope. I went to an icy, watery grave. I mean, let's be honest. That should have been expected. I should have been like... I don't know why I'm surprised by that, because... Ooh, wood. Gotta have your morning wood. I mean, it is 4:30 in the morning. Link's gotta get his morning wood. I mean, it's freezing cold water. I don't care if you're wearing warm clothes. You're gonna freeze to death in icy water. I mean, unless you're those, like, freaks who want to break world records, and they're all like, I'm gonna go submerge myself in waters of Alaska in the Arctic Circle, and I'll stay in there for like 30 minutes to break a world record and, you know, potentially die. You know, because risking death is worth getting my name in a book. Woo! That's what I want to do. I want my children to know after I'm dead that I died because all I wanted was my name in a book. Hi. Hi. Oh yeah, they explode. I forgot they explode. Damn white choo-choos. Are there more choo-choos? There are more choo-choos. I remember how to deal with you. I just gotta get you to do what I need you to do. There we go. Nope, nope. No, don't you. No. That stopped him from icing up again. There we go. No icing for them. All the icing is for me. Because it's my cake, and I can have all the icing I want. You can't take it. Alright. Just as a reminder, I'm not wearing any headphones because I can't hear the game. My setup has prevented me from doing so. I still never figured it out. What the hell was that? Did anyone see the screen shake, or was that just me? Getting stuff. La da di da di da, get stuff. Okay, there's a cobblin camp over there. Might have some stuff, but I'm gonna go up the mountain. I want to go up the mountain. Like I said before, if this is my personal file, I'd be all about, you know, searching every nook and cranny. But, you know, when you're trying to do a YouTube Let's Play, one that Nintendo won't rape you for, and especially, you know, you're on a time limit, you can't explore as much as you would like to. As much as I would like to, at least. I love to explore. I love games like this. I just do. I want some bombs. It's just, this game is so good, guys. I mean, this one of the reasons I'm showing this to you is because I don't want you just to take my word for it. I don't want you to be like, well, Featherhoof says it's good. All the magazines are giving it perfect scores. I mean, I want you to see it. I want you to see it in action. I want you to see how good and awesome this game is. Oh my god, just look at that world. Imagine it, if you had a Wii U or a Switch, you could be in this world too. I mean, all you have to do is for the low price of one Wii U or Switch. Come on, you know you want to. Come on, Bose. It's worth it, it really is. This game just is so, like, I can't stop, I can't put it down. I'm playing it a second time for you guys, just to show you this game. Again, bit of it. Not going to do like a full, you know, Critical Path Let's Play. Because, let's be honest about what it is. I don't think you can, well, I can't do a full Let's Play without, without exploring. Because when you explore, you know, doing all the shrines and getting all the upgrades, and everything like that, that I need to do that. So I can get more hearts and I can get more stamina and stuff like that. I cannot, and just simply cannot, go through the game, you know, not only having 3 hearts. Or in, you know, 1 stamina circle. I can't do it. And it would be a massive undertaking for me to go through the game a second time, going through every shrine a second time, doing everything a second time while trying, you know, to enjoy my own personal playthrough. It isn't gonna happen. So I'm just gonna show you like I said, I'm showing you some of the game. Okay, I thought that, you know, the cracks and stuff in there, I thought it was gonna break. Oh, icy water. Icy water is bad. No touchy. Kenamot. I wonder where they get these names. This is like the made-up Hylian language. Oh yes, no skipping. Why am I sitting here watching it? I'm so used to watching cutscenes, I'm just like... Oh, that's right, it's a cutscene, I can skip it. This is really like the first game ever, man, where I'm just like skip, cutscene, skip, cutscene, skip, cutscene. Usually I like watching cutscenes. I do. And it's just these cutscenes, just these that I skip. Because I don't need to be see the same message 120 times. I don't need to see the same opening of the door 120 times. Don't need it. I'm sure somebody needs it. It isn't me. Now, here's an ability I use a lot. I find that I use a skill quite a lot. My Cryosis. Cryosis? How do you pronounce it? I say Cryosis. I don't know if that's... A Cryonis, I'm sorry. Cryonis. Create a pillar of ice from a water surface. Builds ice pillars that are very stable. These pillars can be used as stepping stones or as obstacles. Use Cryonis as on an ice pillar to break it. So if you can only put down three at a time. If you put down more than three, first one's broke. Remember that. Remember the third ice pillar. And there we are. Ice pillar. Not enough. Woo, woo. There we go. It's like I didn't put it close enough. Yay. Now I did. Now. Ah. And we can also open. There's going to be several times in the game where you just use it to open gates. Wait. Oh, hi, you. Actually, can I? Nope. Ha ha ha, bitch. Oh, I thought that maybe I could use that to hurt him, but does not appear to be the case. No! Chuck ya! No eye lasers from you! Actually, I wish I had an eye laser ability. I wish I could just, like, rip their head off and, like, use it as, like, a laser gun. That would be awesome. Oh, yes. This way? And we go up here. I put another one, just because I can. There we go. I didn't have to do that. There was absolutely no reason to do that, but I wanted to. And you can't stop me. Oh, I should have waited anyway. God damn it. Now I gotta go back up it anyway, which means I'm going to have to destroy one of my, Oh, bloody hell. Go away. Because it doesn't count unless you actually take the item from the chest. Okay, I'll break you. You know, is that all the chests from here? All the chests from here. Now, we find our way to the final Spirit Orb! Well, of the tutorial! Your resourcefulness in overcoming this trial speaks to the promise of a hero! In the name of Goddess Highly, I bestow upon you this Spirit Orb! This one is good for one free candy, less than $3. At the concession stand. Goodbye, skipping. I'm done. Thank you. May the goddess smile upon you. Don't skip this, oh shit. Yay, we now have all four. Uh-oh. It's Santa Claus.
With this, you have now acquired all of the spirit orbs from the shrines on this plateau. Oh, ho, ho, extraordinary! That means it is finally time. Link, it's finally time for me to tell you everything. But first, take off your pants. Imagine an X on your map with the four shrines as the endpoints. Find the spot where those lines intersect. I shall wait for you there.
Or, you know, you could just point at it, which you just did.
You understand where the new line connecting the shrines would cross there? I will be waiting, ding, ding.
Uh-oh. He disappeared. So, pretty simple. Let's draw an X. Oh yeah, I died there. That's one line there, and one line there. Now, if only there was a thing right there where they intersected. If only there was a thing right there. It'll go right there. Okay, now we get down the mountain. First, I'm going to get me a treasure chest, because it's right here to get, and I want it. Yoink. Yoink. And... Might. Must not touch that water. That's deadly ice water. Opal. Yay. Don't touch the water. Don't touch the water. Don't touch the water. Get out of the water. Oh. Oh, bad. Double plus bad. Okay, well, tell you guys what. I'm going to insert a jump cut until we get to the Temple of Time. Or until something cool happens. So... Inserting jump cut. Okay, and we're back. We're here to meet Santa Claus's invitation. He said to come to where the X crosses. This is where the X crosses. And we has a shiny. Hi, shiny. How you doing? Remember when I said those spirit orbs were used for upgrading? That's what we're here for. He's a happy goddess. Look at her. She has all her tiny goddesses around her.
You who have conquered the shrines and claimed the spirit orbs, I can offer you great power. It appears you have claimed 4 spirit orbs. In exchange for 4 spirit orbs, I will amplify your being. So tell me what it is that you desire.
So here's the fun part, where this game is just so fucking customizable, and I love it. You can choose, for every 4, you can choose a heart container or a stamina vessel. You're not beholden to it. There's actually a way to, like, if you wanted to change it, you can change it. Cost rupees, but you can change it. I, myself, I've always been a middle-of-the-road guy. I like to be a jack-of-all-trades, but a master of none. That's always been my favorite way to play games that are fully customizable like this. So every 4, I go back and forth. I go heart, stamina, heart, stamina, heart, stamina. So that, and by doing the math, there's 120 shrines. You know, so every 4, you divide 120 by 4, that's 30. So that's 30 upgrades, so 15 hearts, 15 stamina vessels. So that's, in the end, that's 18 hearts and 4 full stamina wheels. But I've heard, like, Polygon says, like, no hearts, go all stamina. It's the best way to play this game. I'm like, not if I die constantly. And you guys have seen my Let's Plays. I die constantly. So I'm going for a heart container. Gimme. That is the power I seek. The power to not die. That is a big heart. I don't know how it's going to fit in his chest, but... apparently they figured it out. Your life force has been strengthened, increasing your maximum number of hearts by 1. Bing!
Go and bring peace to Hyrule. Shemon.
Oh, I hear the Santa Claus.
The blessing of the goddess has made you that much more resilient, I see. Here I am. Get up here.
Quickly.
And don't forget to take off your pants.
I forgot that it ended up there. Going up there in the, what was it, last episode? Episode before? I went up here to go get that arrow, the bow and arrow. I forgot, like, oh yeah, it's kind of pointless, because you go up here and so the story takes you this way. Up, come on. I mean, God, you'd think Link would never climbed a roof in his life or anything. Not that I can talk being afraid of heights and all. I'm afraid of a lot of things when I think about it. Okay, this is talky bit, so I don't think I have to talk over this.
Well done there, young one. Now then, The time has come to show you who I truly am.
I was supposed to tell you this when you moved into the neighborhood because of the court order, but I am the king. Also a sexual predator.
A kingdom which no longer exists.
Yeah, there was all kinds of, like, problems with taxes, and people didn't want to pay them, and we totally went bankrupt as a kingdom. It was horrible.
The Great Calamity
was
merciless.
That is an awful outfit.
It devastated everything in its path, Lo. A century ago, it was then that my life was taken away from me. And since that time,
I got into World of Warcraft.
Spirit form.
My life was totally stolen.
To overwhelm you while your memory was still fragile. So rather than that, I thought it best to assume a temporary form. Forgive me. I think
God, look at the way he looks at me sideways. Like he's like,
to hear what
I'm still better than you.
100 years ago. To know Calamity Ganon's true form, one must know the story from an age long past. The Demon King was born into this kingdom, but his transformation into malice created the horror you see now. Stories of Ganon.
See, that's what I'm curious about, and I haven't even gotten that far in my own game.
Form of
is that, why is he this giant cloud of death now? What happened to being the red-haired, dark-skinned guy from the desert?
The
or the giant pig man? What is the cloud of death?
The power to oppose it lies dormant beneath the ground. We decided to heed the prophecy and began excavating large areas of land.
That looks like it took a long time.
Several ancient relics.
Those guys are making no headway.
Of our distant ancestors. These relics, the divine beasts.
Oh wow!
Were giant machines.
Someone made some headway.
By warriors. We also found the Guardians, an army of mechanical soldiers who fought autonomously. This coincided with ancient legends oft repeated throughout our land.
Did it now, because I don't remember these legends. Perhaps of someone named Zelda. I mean, who would tell such a tale?
It was they who sealed Ganon away using the power of these ancient relics. 100 years ago, there was a princess set to inherit a sacred power and a skilled knight at her side.
Was there now?
It was clear that we must follow our ancestors' path.
Was it really clear, though? Was it?
We selected four skilled individuals from across Hyrule and tasked them with the duty.
Or are you just sort of like grasping at straws?
With the princess as their commander, we dubbed these pilots champions. A name that would solidify.
I want to just dub them the Power Rangers. There's five of them. And they each have a different
the
weapon there.
Her appointed knight and
multicolored.
The rest of the champions were on the brink
go,
of
go, Power Rangers!
Ganon. But nay. Ganon
but nay. The champions fucked up and we all died. Uh-oh. You're all screwed.
He appeared from deep below Hyrule Castle, seized control of the Guardians and the Divine Beasts, and turned them against us.
Whoopsie! Didn't see that one coming, did they?
Those residing in the castle as well. The appointed knight gravely collapsed.
This is so cool. This game starts with the concept of, guess what? The
and
bad guy won.
The kingdom of Hyrule was devastated absolutely by Calamity Ganon.
Like millions and like hundreds of thousands of people
However,
died.
The princess survived to face Ganon alone.
Link, you are our final
hope. Ooh, hi Triforce.
The fate of Hyrule rests with you.
I was just talking to a friend last night about how I've been playing this for like 20, 30, 40 hours now, and they haven't mentioned the word Triforce once.
That princess was my own daughter, my dear Zelda.
Yeah, you're king, she's princess, that kind of goes hand in hand, you didn't have to say
right
it.
Up to the very end. that night.
God, your schnoz is huge. Oh, I'm sorry, me? Oh, yes, it was me, but could you say it without distracting me with your giant, huge nose? You could perch a bird on the end of that.
Here you now stand, revitalized 100 years later. The words of guidance you have been hearing since your awakening are from Princess Zelda herself. Even now, as she works to restrain Ganon from within
Hyrule Castle, she's got some good cell coverage. I wonder what company she goes through. Definitely not AT&T.
My daughter's power will soon be
exhausted. Maybe Verizon, but well, she has a princess. She should be able to afford a Verizon.
Regenerate himself, and nothing will stop him from consuming our land. Considering that I could not save my own kingdom,
I love this look on his face. He's like, this of you, Link. I can see his mouth moving. He's telling me something, but I checked out like 10 minutes ago.
Here. You must save her, my daughter.
Oh, that hurt. Okay. Look, he had to. So, you must save her. My daughter, I mean. Ganon, you know, to be more specific.
Control over all four giant beasts.
Excuse me.
As well as those guardians swarming around Hyrule Castle. I believe it would be quite reckless for you to head directly to the castle at this point.
Speedrunners have done it. Speedrunners have done it.
That you make your way east out to one of the villages in the wilderness. Follow the road out to Kakariko Village.
The names never change.
She will tell you more about the path that lies ahead. Consult the map on your Sheikah slate for the precise location of Kakariko Village. Make your way past the twin summits of the dueling peaks. From there, follow the road.
You mean those things, like, north. Clearly framed in the center of the screen?
Go on, here is the paraglider, just as I promised. Ta-da-da-da!
An item that you received from the king on the Great Plateau. It allows you to sail through the skies. Press X while you're in the air to use it. The Isolated Plateau, completed!
With that, you should be able to safely fly off the cliffs surrounding this area. And I think that's it. I've told you everything I can. Link, you must save Hyrule.
New objective, destroy Ganon. You don't say. Seek out Impa. You don't say. Okay, those must be our only objectives. Well, those objectives, which are right over yonder, will be things we will do in another episode, because I have to end this one here. We now have the paraglider, we can get our asses off this plateau and start our journey. But that'll be it for next time. If you enjoyed this one, however, please let me know with a like, comment, subscribe, share it, or you can click on the annotations for other videos I've done. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all next time.